2007, George A. Romero comes back, another zombie movie. Awesome, I was excited again. I'm like, yeah, well, let's give it another shot, George. Diary of the Dead.
Two news agencies are reporting accounts of the dead returning to life.
Free! Ah!
What's that?
What was that?
You can't talk about it. It's an epidemic. Being an epidemic.
What is this about, Jason?
This turns out to be a big thing. I just want to record it.
For this sort of failure, like a major disease organization.
Look. Looks hurt.
He's all burned up.
The problem doesn't seem to be that people are waking up dead. The dead people are waking up.
Diary of the Dead, it appears to be kind of a contemporary retelling of Night of the Living Dead, using, you know, our modern technology and the way our modern society has evolved as a context to how the zombie epidemic would go down these days, as opposed to 1968. In this movie, a group of film students are out shooting a horror movie when, they get word that something's going on out there in the real world, and then they find out people are coming back to life and they're trying to eat each other. So they take their video camera and they decide to document the whole zombie epidemic while it's going on.
You're saying they're all dead?
Yes.
This is a hospital. There's nobody here.
This is a diary of cruelty.
Come on, before we get our asses shot off.
Do this anymore. Every time we walk in somewhere, somebody dies.
So this movie basically takes the found footage approach and combines it, interestingly enough, with, you know, a traditional movie. So that's actually kind of cool. I think that's kind of cool. I've never really seen that done, at least not to this extent. So it's a good idea. He didn't just go straight found footage. He didn't just go straight traditional. He blended the two. So I understand where George was coming from. I know exactly what he was trying to say. I think it's a relevant message. I think it's a powerful message. He's talking about the way society has become obsessed with video or looking at the world through cameras instead of actually experiencing and witnessing what's going on in front of you. You're looking at it through a viewfinder, or everything's got to be caught on film or it didn't really happen. All that stuff is definitely classic Romero. You know, the way he's pointing out these things about our society. So I get all that. Really, I'd say this is actually a pretty good movie, with the exception of the found footage aspect, which, oddly enough, is one of the main things, the main theme about the movie. So it's like a double-edged sword. It's the main theme, and he's getting a very powerful and, you know, understandable, relatable point across. Yet the whole found footage thing is still, it just doesn't quite work. Now, I'm not a big hater of found footage movies like a lot of people are. There's some of them that I like. However, that whole gimmick has definitely run its course. We need to just stop making found footage movies unless somebody can do it decently. Really, the biggest issue I have when I'm watching a found footage movie is I always get taken out of the movie every time the character insists on filming when any normal person would drop the camera and run. When I'm watching one of these found footage movies, like every 10 minutes, I get taken out of the movie because I'm like, oh, come on, nobody would just stop and film that. Run or do something. So that's really, you know, my biggest issue with this movie is the fact that I keep getting taken out of the story of what's going on because I'm like, come on, no, that's not realistic. People wouldn't behave that way. So, but I will say this much. I did really like the special effects. I thought they were really well done. I believe they were accomplished by an FX company called Spin. I'm not a big gore person myself. However, when it's done right, I may not like to see a lot of gore, but when it's done right, I can appreciate that, you know, the art and the skill and the craft that goes into it. And even though a lot of this is CG in this movie, I feel like they did a really good job on it. It actually looks pretty decent. I was pretty impressed. So ultimately, Diary of the Dead, I consider it a valiant effort on Romero's part. I understand the message he was trying to send. I think he actually did accomplish getting that message across, and it's very relevant for today's modern world. However, the movie kind of stumbles on itself. doesn't quite live up to what a Romero zombie movie should be. I think I'll give it... I'm going to give it 2.5 out of 5 stars.
Christ. Jesus Christ. I thought the Amish were friendly folk.
Fucking ingenious.